I'm Dr. John C. Savage, and this is Jane Pataev, and we are again working on my impromptu for solo flute. We're going to start at the section marked more aggressively and with tone, the 7-8 to 4-4 section. Let's play a little Jane. Good. So, good 7-8. I think, again, one of the trickier parts of this piece is the flipping between different sounds. So you have this 7-8 to 4-4 thing, and I always tell people, kind of, again, like I mentioned in another section, really groove with it. Okay. You know? Sometimes I think, like, the term lay back, it could mean just being in the groove and not rushing far forward, and enjoy the sound more. Enjoy the sound, you know. Rush, the band Rush has retired from performing, so, you know, some flutist is going to have to carry the torch now. But also, so keeping the groove and trying to really at the beginning here delineate the sounds. I would try to dig into the A's a little more.
Okay.
So this is based on a half-whole diminished scale, or an octatonic scale, which is 8 tones. Basically, starting on G sharp, if you went half-whole, half-whole. But it has a few other notes thrown in occasionally, in E natural, for example. But that was better. See if you can get a little more edge on those.
Okay.
And then when you go up, it goes up the octave. Really, it's marked double forte. Really bring that out. That was good, because like with a lot of contemporary or new music, you really want to have those nuances. You want to really have them stand out.
Mm-hmm.
So I kind of think of this section as the thing that you kind of always want to do as a flutist, but you're not supposed to, which is crack your sound.
Mm-hmm.
But here it's a balance between cracking the sound and then playing really, really strongly with a strong tone. So that's the challenge here. Let's play this where we get these multiphonics. This is my favorite part, I think, here. How about start here?
Okay.
Or at the beginning of the 7-8, that makes sense. Nice. My feeling on this is sort of that just because of the register the flute's written in, in between the multiphonics.
Mm-hmm.
It's weird playing that without putting the multiphonics. because of where the register is, it's sometimes good in a way, just like I remember my undergraduate teacher saying in like the Bach partita, maybe don't play the stuff in the upper register or, you know, quite so loud in a Baroque piece like that, where you have a lot of jumping around, for
mm-hmm.
example. Bring out, in this sense, instead of bringing out the bottom notes, you want to bring out the multiphonics. So really voice the best multiphonics you can get. really make those resonant, and then maybe back off on the others, on the other notes, just to make them, just play them in good time with a good sound. But down, it's not written this way, but to balance multiphonics, you're actually doing the opposite of what often people say, which is overblowing. You actually don't want to overblow multiphonics at all. Mm-hmm. You lose them. You want to I like using the word, but you want to voice them. You want each part, each element of the multiphonic, each note to speak clearly. And then if you need to, adjust the volume around them, around the multiphonic to make them sound louder. Try that.
Just the multiphonics?
Yeah, or try, how about from that measure, from that 4-4 bar? Okay. That's great. That sounds really great. Let's move on to the percussive section down here. Maybe a little bit of rushing in part of it, but
okay.
But really pretty solid. There's a Billy Higgins, the drummer, jazz drummer, Billy Higgins drum solo on an Andrew Hill album that I love his beat coming out of all the solos, and that's what I imagine in my head. Anyway, that groove, if you keep that groove in your head, that'll help. And your sounds all sound wonderful. They're all coming out great. sometimes people have a question of, you know, what types of percussive sounds we should use. In this one, do this part over here again after that tremolo. So that one right there, some people so it's written as a low B, and I've used what I would call a tongue pizzicato sound. I draw the tongue between the lips often. Or what you're doing is kind of a beatboxy style,
mm-hmm.
puh, kind of. Either one works, I think. My preference might be more to the tongue pits. It's just a slightly different part of the drum set.
Okay.
That might be my preference, but either one is fine. And then the last part of this, you can really bring out the accentuation where when you move your slide your middle finger on the left hand. You could actually, like, I open my mouth a little bit more on that one. So here's if I don't open my mouth. But I can accent it by opening my mouth. Gives more of the higher frequencies in.
Mm-hmm.